Right. Lessons in Love by Sinead Harnett. Before Sinead Harnett started making noise, she was a fan of artists like the Fugees, Whitney Houston, Michael Jackson, and Amy Winehouse, amongst others. She grew up in North London, where she studied for a degree in acting. With her debut album, does she show she's ready for the spotlight? How do we feel about it? Here's our honest review of Lessons in Love by Sinead Harnett.
Lessons in Love by Sinead Harnett.
Yes, sir.
If I don't call her by her first name again, it's only because I'm going to mess it up. With that being said, how do you feel about this album artwork?
I actually thought it was pretty dope. It's a like a different kind of shot, you know. It's just, I don't know. I like it because it's kind of off place with the text being to the right side and everything like that. And it's just really, I want to say, kind of creative. I like the background and the texture that it creates with the white that she's wearing. So I thought it was pretty dope.
Yeah, it's a sexy little artwork cover. You know what I'm saying? She's sitting there. Looks like she's just wearing like a long shirt and she's just sitting there. It's weird, but I just find it funny that like people get to keep their feet looking clean when they take shots like that, because it just lets me know that you just took your shoes off right before you took the picture. It's stupid, right?
Okay.
But right. It's a cool shot, and the text is actually really clean. It gives it a really clean look. The flow of this album, man, is pretty much what the album name says. It's Lessons in Love. That's really all you can say about it, really.
Yes, Lessons in Love. Each track is a different lesson, pretty much.
Super facts. All right, highlights, y'all. Highlights. I want to skip to my favorite songs first.
What's that?
If You Let Me featuring Grade.
That song's fire.
That joint is amazing. Yeah. Especially when the guitar gets a little heavier, when she says a little part in the hook, that joint sounds amazing.
Yes.
Pulling Away featuring Gallant. We came in, I ran across Gallant not that long ago on accident. I think I sent you one of his songs.
Did you? I don't remember.
Maybe I sent it to her. But it was a one Gallant song, and I was just like, man, this dude's a beast. Pops up on Sinead Harnett's album. That song is amazing. I love it. Too Good for a Bad Thing. Oh my goodness. When y'all listen to that song, you gotta be like a weak, heartless motherfucker not to like that song. Because the song, I'm just saying, like, it is just so dope.
Yeah.
Him Too is extremely well written. I commend her for writing a song like that, because most people wouldn't give a shit. They just be like, hey, I'm sorry, I love him too. It's just like, hey, you messed up, and I'm up next. So that's your fault.
Yes.
Yeah, she got some compassion. Like, look, y'all broke up. I'm sorry.
I love him too.
But I like him too, so I'm not moving on. Nah, that's too nice. It was too friendly. And on top of that, like, I just don't think those songs are extremely amazing. And I thought Lessons is another song that's actually really, really well. And All That You Are is another one of those songs. I love the way she's singing on that song. That's, man, it is so fire. She's got some real soul in these songs here.
Yeah, man. That's why almost basically every track on here is a highlight to me. I really love how the title went with the track list, Lessons in Love. And I feel like each song went through that thoroughly. Starting off with Lessons, man, that was just a very dope way to start off. I mean, self-explanatory, but still, it was a powerful way to start off. And I'm with you. If You Let Me is fire. Like, I kept coming back to that song time and time again. Leo Bear, I just like the name of it because I'm a Leo, and I think that's really dope. So I thought that was dope. The song was really, really fire. Pulling Away was great. All That You Are is amazing. I really love the sound of that. Too Good for a Bad Thing is straight fire. I'm with you on Him Too, because I'm just like, oh, she really pulling this perspective like this. And it's just like, is she about to, like, I thought she was going to take the perspective of, like, you know, she's cheating on him or something like that, but she was like, no, he moving on, I'm with him now. So I thought that was really, really dope. And I'm loving the way how it ended with Living and Walking Away, because I feel like that's another part of being a Lessons in Love. Like, you gotta live and you gotta learn how to walk away, not walk away from self, because she said, I'm not walking away from me.
Yeah.
So I thought that was pretty dope. Really, really dope writing on here, and like you said, a lot of soul in the lyrics.
Low lights. So Leo Bear, I wasn't rocking with it. Shout out to her nephew, but I wasn't rocking. It's a cool song, but I wasn't rocking.
Oh, man.
I thought the Be By Myself, I was a little bored with that one.
Okay.
Living, I was just kind of like, we need to get away from that idea that, like, about you're not living if you're not with somebody else. Like,
I could understand.
But it's not. It just seems like it's a somewhat counterproductive mentality. Especially when she, I mean, it's just me. It was a stage on the project. Yeah, exactly. It was a stage on the project. So it actually makes sense in the context of the project. And then Be The One, I thought it was cool, but I wish it was just a little bit longer. I wish she would have turned that into a full song.
Yeah, yeah.
That was it.
Yeah, that's my only old, like, it's Be The One. I wanted that to be a full song. I didn't really think that should have been an interlude. Give us the full song, because there was no other interludes on this album. So that should have been a full song. But other than that, that's it.
Final thoughts, man. Sinead, right?
Yep.
She killed this joint vocally. She's got the white girl got soul, man.
Yes.
That's at the end of the day, that's the main topic. You know what I'm saying? She's super soulful. She's got some dope collabs up here, and I think she's gonna be. Yo, I don't think y'all understand. UK is crushing the R&B right now. You know what I'm saying?
Yes.
Like Mahalia and LMA just put a video out. Yeah, for
that. Yeah, that was pretty
You know
dope.
What I'm saying?
Yeah.
We did Etta Bomb. We did her. You got Marsha Ambrosia. Yeah, Lady Lesha. I know she's not a singer, but she's a rapper. But yeah. The R&B that's coming out of the UK is ridiculous this year.
Yes.
I feel like they might have that R&B in like a headlock. And I'm talking about they're touching into the soul of R&B.
Yeah.
America need to catch back up.
Yes.
This reminds me of like the 70s rock and roll music when the UK was killing the rock scene with like Queen and Rolling Stones and stuff like that.
Yeah, man. She made a statement with this, and she's here to stay. And I really loved how she brought across her lessons in love. I feel like each track gave a different avenue of her artistry. And I think she killed it with this, man. I feel like there's going to be a song for everybody on this project that you can relate to or you can pass on to somebody. Like, hey, you need to listen to this because you might be going through this. So I feel like this is a very strong project for a lot of people to rub off of.
Final grade. I'm giving it a check. And if you ain't giving it a check,
something wrong with you.
You ain't been through puberty yet.
Oh, my gosh.
Because you obviously don't know nothing about love yet.
Oh, man.
I mean, that's just all I get from it, man. This joint, this project is hard. Super soulful singing. I actually watched a video of her singing If You Let Me, singing it live.
Okay.
It sounds great.
That's what's up.
The guitarist, she just had a drummer and a guitarist in there. She was singing and she was going in, man. And
what's up?
Yo, shout out to Sinead. She is a beast, man. She's something special in this industry.
Yeah, man. Most definitely a check from me. Y'all need to listen to this. Y'all need to tell all your friends, significant others, whatever about this, because this is some dope stuff to listen to reflect on, think about. It's just really good soulful music.